The first dish that I'm going to be doing is kind of a braised oxtail, and of course we are using great oxtail from the Big Island. It's nice and tender. It becomes very, very moist when you cook it for a long time, and to me, when you cook, building a lot of depth is to me where the flavor comes from. So just by sauteing a piece of meat, granted, it's great, and you're going to get the flavor, as I'll explain later on, for a tenderloin. But I really enjoy building the flavors in a dish by using a piece of meat like an oxtail. So I'm going to just take these pieces that we had cut up earlier, and then I'm going to salt and pepper the oxtail and start off with a little bit of oil. And we use grapeseed oil, or you can use olive oil. As you know, we're not going to be able to finish this dish in 30 minutes, but I can kind of give you the gist of what we're doing here. So naturally, what I try to do is caramelize the meat. And then to this, I'm going to be adding some lemongrass, some ginger, kaffir lime leaf, onions, and then we have some shallots, and then we have some whole garlic. And what I try to do is saute all of this together to kind of get the aromatics going. And sometimes what I try to do is char some of the, not really char, but kind of like give color to the fat itself. So what we're trying to do here is extract all these great flavors from these aromatics and some of these vegetables, and then incorporate the flavors all together from, you know, also extracting the beef flavor, the fat flavor from the oxtails itself, and then we're gonna kind of make this curry sauce. And the reason why I don't like to brown the vegetables too much also is because I don't want that so-called burnt flavor, you know, because what I tend to do a lot is to reduce a lot of my sauces. So if there's a charred taste in the beginning, as I reduce the liquid, it becomes even stronger. So trying to eliminate that, you know, to me, I always tend to not brown things too much in the beginning. And then to this, I'm going to add the coconut milk. And then you can use some braising liquid, or you can, of course, you can use some water. But normally, I would cook in a vessel like this, where it's a lot higher and a lot so-called smaller, so that I can get all the liquid. You know, so for 2, 4, 5, 6 pieces of oxtail that may come to here, then I want that liquid to come to about here, because I know that if the liquid is that high, you know, and I cook it real slow, as it reduces, all the flavor is being built up and getting concentrated. I would recommend, when you make something like this, especially like an oxtail, that you don't make it today and serve it today. What I would suggest is that you cook it really slow on a Monday, and then after it's done, you don't reduce the sauce all the way. What happens is, what you want to do is kind of like let your liquids not even simmer. Simmer is about 180 degrees or so. But you let it kind of like almost to a simmer, and you just let it go slow. Because the reason why I would do that is because oxtail has a lot of fat. And when you boil it, the fat really incorporates into the sauce. And I'm not saying that that's bad or good. I'm just saying that to a lot of people, if you don't want to have all that fat in your dish itself, you can cook it a lot slower. And as you reduce or cook the oxtail, the liquid is all here. You kind of let it go like this. The meat cooks. And then you take the meat out. And then what you do is you let the sauce stay overnight. After it cools, put it in the refrigerator. You let it sit overnight. And then what happens is all the fat floats to the top. And then the next day, you can skim all the fat off. And then you can reduce the coconut milk and have an incredible sauce. Because I don't want to flavor the sauce in the beginning, all of it, and then find out that it's something goes wrong at the end. What I always do is save some of my most important flavorings to the end. So we have some dry curry. And again, you know, you can change the proportions as you like, but you know, a lot of times you see a lot of chefs really start to cook the curry in the saucepan and get it, you know, a lot of chefs use it to bring out the flavor. And they kind of like saute it in butter or oil, but usually I don't do that again because I don't want that harsh flavor. I'm more of a guy who likes the mellow flavors of some of the ingredients. So even though I want that punch, for the dried curry, I'm not a huge fan of really caramelizing it. I'm more of a guy that likes to get it more yellow, and then just having that flavor of that curry that come out at you over a long period of time. And then to this, I'm going to be adding some of the red Thai curry. And then to counterbalance or to sweeten that spiciness of the curry, what I do is I add palm sugar, okay? And there's a reasoning for me to use palm sugar. I think it really has a lot of depth in the flavor. Very aromatic, you know, it just tastes good. And you can get different types, or you can get different grades, different types, different colors. But after you sweeten it up, you have to kind of adjust it again. So what I do is I end up adding some fish sauce. I hardly use salt. I always end up using some sort of other alternative. And usually I go to either soy sauce or I go to fish sauce. And then what I'll do is I'll just kind of like, I would just kind of garnish. Oxtail, if I were to make it from start to finish, letting everything rest, you know, taking the fat off, and without taking the full day, from start to finish to do it in one day, I would spend about maybe almost 8 hours on this one dish. Because reduce the sauce really slow, and then in between I would let the sauce rest, and then I would cook it back again. But that's just my passion. That's just how I enjoy cooking. So that's our first dish right here. So if you can see that.